While small dogs such as the toy poodle and miniature poodle have a bad reputation for being barkers, this is simply not true. All dogs bark and they all have a reason for doing so. The key to stop unwanted barking is to understand why your poodle is barking and then to take steps to resolve that issue. Let's take a look at the reasons a poodle will bark and what you can do to help both your dog and your ears. Before I move on with the video, I want to ask you a simple question. Do you want to train your dog for any basic commands like sit and stay? Do you want to stop any of the behavioral problems of your dog like pooping inside the house, biting, jumping, or barking? If your answer is yes, please grab the free dog training secrets guide in which I have disclosed the deepest dog training secrets that professional dog trainers don't want you to know about. These training secrets would help you have a well-behaved, super intelligent, smart and obedient dog without spending hours in training him or her. This secret training technique ebook is available for free only for a limited time. So go and grab it before it's too late. Link to the free ebook and training videos is in the description below. Triggered barking. One of the most common reasons for a poodle to bark is trigger barking. This simply means that something, whether it is a situation or a noise, is causing your dog to bark. The most common reason for triggered barking are being left home alone, guests entering the home, cars or people walking by, weather, especially thunderstorms. In these cases, training and socialization can resolve the issue. When a dog has a hard time coping with being left home alone, this is called separation anxiety. We have a separate section just for this, and you can find much more information here regarding separation anxiety. Barking at guests, at people, cars going by. Barking when the doorbell rings and other similar barking episodes happens when a poodle needs socialization training. Socializing a dog is very necessary to help a dog gain self-esteem and to behave properly in many situations, and it is not as complicated as you may think. The method of socializing a dog to the above situations or other similar ones is to offer slow exposure to the triggers that causes the barking. However, it must be done in a particular way. Two important keys to remember is that in order for this training and socializing to work, an owner must 1. Be committed to the goal. One must not give up after just a day or two, and training must be consistent. 2. Praise must be given whenever your poodle is behaving as you wish. This is often referred to as positive reinforcement, and just as important as to not offer negative reinforcement. It is human instinct to want to say no, or to vocally reprimand a dog when they are behaving in a way that is not wanted. However, the key to successful training, especially when it comes to socialization, is to ignore your poodle when they are barking or barking, and jumping any negative behavior must be ignored. When a poodle, or any other dog for that matter, is given attention, even negative attention, they will not fully understand what is expected. Dogs, particularly poodles, thrive on human companionship and interaction. When that is taken away, even briefly, the poodle understands the message must faster than if you were to say no. Barking in response to thunder and lightning storms is completely different than barking at cars or people. The majority of dogs have a heightened sense of awareness during storms. Other reasons why a poodle may bark. Protecting you. Your poodle, no matter which sized poodle you have, will often be very protective. Barking at guests, cars and passing people is actually your dog's way of protecting you from what they perceive to be a threat. The important element to remember is that even though there is no threat to your poodle, it is very logical that these triggers are potential threats. The key to stopping this type of barking is to show your dog that there is no threat. The best way to do this is by your actions and your words. Poodles are very aware of their owner's actions and words and will look to them to validate what they are doing, in this case barking. If an owner remains calm, this is the best method to show your poodle that they also can be calm. Self-protection. Poodles can be very territorial. And this is not necessarily a bad thing. It is important for a dog to know that certain items are their belongings. However, overprotecting those items can induce unwanted barking. The most common reason for self-protection is when a poodle feels the need to guard their food and water dishes, even if they are empty at the time, and to protect their toys. Always keeping their dishes in a quiet corner of a room is important. When your poodle eats, have all family members keep a distance. Owners are not even aware that they cause a poodle to be protective of food dishes because this behavior is often mistakenly instilled when a poodle is just a small puppy. New owners want to be close and take pleasure watching their puppy eat. However, over time, this causes a puppy to feel as if they need to protect what is most important to them, their food. A dog can live without many things, but they know that they need food for survival. For this reason, all family members should be sure to allow a dog to eat in peace. This means no picture taking and no giving praise for eating. Also be sure that even if their food dishes are in a corner of the kitchen, that their meals are not given when the kitchen is filled with people. Boredom. Another reason why a poodle barks is boredom. Dogs may bark incessantly if they are not socialized at a young age and if they are not supplied with a variety of dog toys. Giving your poodle lots of different toys is not spoiling them. Toys are very important to dogs of all ages. It works well to have two groups of toys, although always keeping any dog toys that your poodle has become very attached to. In this way, you can switch toy collections every week or every 2 weeks. This essentially offers your dog new toys without having to constantly buy new ones. Toys should be colorful, have interesting textures and be interactive. Excitement. Many poodles bark due to excitement. This is very common with puppies and some can get so excited that they lose control of the bladder. This is not a house training issue, it is a behavioral issue and will ebb away as your puppy grows older. Older poodles can become very excited when left home alone during the day. Excitement over their owner's return can cause some poodles to almost enter a stage of frenzied excitement. For both situations, of a puppy or older poodle, the way in which you enter the home can make a big difference. The action of you opening the door and entering is the trigger. The best treatment for this is to expose your dog to the stimulus that excites them, over and over until it no longer excites them. Do you want to have a well-behaved, obedient and calm pet dog without spending hours in training him? Check out the first link in the description and download the Secret Training Technique guide absolutely free. It is available for free only for a limited period of time. Thanks for watching the video. Comment below if you liked the video. Please subscribe to the channel, Little Paws Training, if you are serious about training and grooming your dog. Also, join our Facebook group where you get all the solutions to your daily doggy problems.